meaningful to the communities. So in order to do that, it's not something ICTA or any one organization could do by itself. I mean, you need a lot of input to have all that rich content out there, which makes a difference to the rural population, makes a difference to a large majority of our people. The ICT agency, recognizing the need to have partnership with other bodies, launched the eSociety Fund. And the eSociety Fund basically had two segments to it. One was we offered smaller grants to community-based organizations, small NGOs, to do ICT-led projects. And here we leveraged on the capabilities of grassroots communities, their understanding of the social mechanisms, and here the technology was not really the end, but the means. It was a tool for transformation. We did not want them to come up with anything new, but it was just leveraging on existing technology to improve themselves. One thing we learned is the approach that we adopted really worked, because we found that no amount of central planning or international best practices introduced from top or from just outside works. It's the agile, systematic learning from grassroots experiences that makes projects like this work. And the fact that we have implemented about 200 such projects, of which we've had our failure rate is only around 5%, and I think that's pretty good considering the type of population, type of communities that we were dealing with. Then the other grants went to bigger organizations. Here we leveraged on their technical capabilities. They were the ones who had bright ideas, like Niranjan, who did Shilpa Saira. They had bright ideas and the technical capability to take a concept to a viable project. But ultimately, the beneficiaries were society, whether it be a community-based project or one of these bigger projects, the ultimate beneficiary was society. I'll just take you through a few of the projects that got done. This is just a few, and like I said, we have over 200. Best job opportunities is a job portal. I mean, you might think there are many job portals, so what's so big about this one? This was done by Anana Sala, and as you know, most of these job portals cater to blue-collar jobs, and they are in English, like top jobs, best jobs. But this one really caters to the more disadvantaged sections of our society. It works with the Samurdhi recipients. The Nana Salone has been working with the Samurdhi Authority, and he's got 72,000 online registrations, and he has gone out, physically collected CVs of about 160,000 people. There are about 100 companies who are registered on the site, and to date, 1,200 people have got employment through this site. Eco Palace is an exploration of cultural heritage in the Sabaragamuwa province. And the Jataka Katha, the Pansiya Panas Jatake, or the 550 stories of the lives of Buddha, is presented digitally in both English and Sinhala language. Lanka Exam Help is really interesting. You know, there are 1.2 million government servants out there who have to, in the course of their career in government service, they have to sit exams, efficiency bar exams, and other promotion exams for which this site prepares them. They're able to get in there and prepare themselves for these exams, which otherwise would not have any kind of support. Sanskrutika Kala Nirmana is a lot of multimedia content, traditional dance rituals, evoking the blessings of gods and the spirits for special occasions like the Sahal Mangalya. And the Hamsayura is the Sunday school syllabus from year one right through to the final. These were all done by small organizations. And these were some of, we've done these bigger projects with about 35 organizations. I just picked out five for you here. Vedananathala was done by the Faculty of Medicine in the University of Colombo. It has around 5,000 articles of health-related on health-related topics, both in all three languages. There is Wikigovia, which is targeting the farmer. It has a range of multimedia content on how to grow, how to deal with pest and disease, how to harvest. There is an agricultural wiki in there. And also there is a forum where farmers can exchange their experiences with a particular fertilizer or whatever. It is very, very interactive. The Sinhala Wikipedia, some years ago, when we started on this project, there was only 380-something articles in the Sinhala Wikipedia. It was probably the smallest wiki that was around. Through this project, we have grown the Sinhala Wikipedia from the 380 to 5,000. I know along the way we've attracted a lot of bouquets and brickbats, but the site has grown. We have also enriched Wikibooks with about 50,000 pages of public domain material. Vidunana is a self-learning software for A-level students. It has biology, mathematics, physics, and chemistry. And the last one there is not just merely content. It is something that is made possible through the internet. Mahavilachya, I think lots of you would have heard of, is a small village in the outskirts of Anuradhapura. It's actually inside the Virpattu jungles. There is a small rural BPO there, On Time Technologies. There are 20, it's a 20-seat BPO. There are young boys and girls, A-level qualified, who are working for John Keyes, which is a blue chip company in Colombo. They're not actually working for John Keyes. On Time Technologies, they own On Time Technologies now, these young boys and girls. And they John Keyes outsource work to this company, and each of them makes around 15 to 20,000 rupees per month. We've replicated this project in Sinigama, which is a tsunami-devastated village in the Gaul district. And we are hoping to also take it to Uduvil in the Jaffna district. Another area of, a huge area of content that we must not overlook is the government content. You know, all of us regularly need to access government content. And citizen access to, just 3 minutes. Giving citizens access to government content is of paramount importance. So we've got over 300 government websites going now. All 300 of them are not 320 something actually. All of them are trilingual. We've got, Mr. Veerathunga talked of the Government Information Center. It is connected to 135 government organizations. There are 100 more in the pipeline, and you can easily access any information about these organizations from their site. The site also provides for handling complaints and grievances. This is my last slide. What are we going to do next? Have we done enough? Can we sit back on our laurels and wait? No, we haven't, because there is much more to get done. We've got to keep this momentum going. I think we've succeeded in creating a lot of interest at the grassroots, amongst NGOs and other organizations, but we have to keep it going. Ruan just mentioned Iswabimani, which is a national award we have introduced to recognize creativity and innovation in digital content.